Hey everyone, this is John DeLeo with another tech tutorial. In this video, I'll be showing you how to create an assignment, but also allow students to know when they should be working on that assignment. There are two ways to create an assignment. You can either go through your course and create it that way, or you can utilize your calendar, which is the way I'll be using today. Once you're in your calendar, up at the top right, there's a plus button, and by clicking it, you'll be presented with some options. I'm gonna click on the assignment tab, and give the assignment a name. For right now, I'll label it test. I'm gonna select the due date by clicking on the little calendar icon, and I'm gonna make this assignment due on the 10th and then press done. The next step is very important. I need to choose the calendar that I wanna put this assignment on. By clicking the dropdown, you'll notice that there are only two options. Well, the reason that there are only two options because on the right-hand side, those are the only courses that I have checked off. So if you want another course to be an option here, you need to make sure that you have that calendar checked off. For the purposes of this video, I'm going to select my training course. And once that's all set, you can press submit. But if you want to put more content in that assignment, let's say a document, or you want to choose how the student is submitting that assignment, we have to go in and click more options. This will bring you to the same assignment page that you would get if you went through the course option. You'll see that I have my rich content editor. I still have my tools at the top. And when I scroll down, I could choose my submission type. And when I get to the bottom, I have the due date that I selected right at the beginning of this tutorial. Once I have it all correct in the way that I want, I'm going to save and publish that assignment. And when you get back to your calendar, you'll see that the assignment is right where I wanted it on the 10th. We know though that students won't necessarily look ahead to work on that assignment since it's due on Friday and we're only on the 6th today. We're gonna utilize an event to let students know that they should be starting work on the 6th and working it throughout the week. I'm gonna go ahead and press the plus button again in the top right. And in this case, I'll be creating an event to let students know they should be working on this assignment. So I'm gonna say work on the test assignment, and I'm gonna select the date that I want the students to be starting their work. So you can see the 6th of April is the day that I want to start my work, which is exactly the date that I have for this week. Once that's all set, I press submit, and that event will show up on the date that I selected. What's cool about events is that you can stretch them out over days. And if you go to the right-hand side of that event by hovering your mouse over it, you'll see that there's a little arrow that shows up. If you click and drag that arrow over multiple days, that event will span out over the dates that I've selected. Now what this really shows us is when the students should be starting their work and when they should be working on that work throughout the week. And this will solve a lot of problems that we have to get our students to start the work when we want them to and not waiting till the last minute. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'd be happy to solve a lot of the problems that we are having in other areas. And I'm trying to help the best way I can, but whether it's through video, whether it's through my office hours, just please reach out to me and let me know if you need any help with any tool that we have.